हरि ओम गीता वुड लाइक टू चैंट द ध्यान श्लोक
हरि ओम यस मैम
प्लीज गो अहेड
ओम पार्थाय प्रतिबोधितां भगवता नारायणेन स्वयं व्यासेन ग्रथितां पुराण मुनिना मध्ये महाभारतम् अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीं भगवतीं अष्टादशाध्यायिनीं अम्ब त्वामनुसन्धदामि भगवद्गीते भवद्वेषिणीं नमोस्तु ते व्यासविशालबुद्धे पुल्लारविन्दायतपत्रनेत्र येन त्वया भारततैलपूर्णः प्रज्वालितो ज्ञानमयः प्रदीपः प्रपन्न पारिजाताय स्तोत्रवेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञानमुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृतदुहे नमः सर्वोपनिषदो गावो दोग्धा गोपालनन्दनः पार्थो वत्ससुधीर्भोक्ता दुग्धं गीतामृतं महत् वसुदेवसुतं देवं कंसचाणूरमर्दनं देवकी परमानन्दं कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुं भीष्मद्रोणतटा जयद्रथजला गान्धारनीलोत्पला शल्यग्राहवती कृपेण वहनी कर्णेन वेलाकुला अश्वत्थामविकर्णघोरमकरा दुर्योधनावर्तिनी सोत्तीर्णा खलु पाण्डवैरणनदी कैवर्तकः केशवः पाराशर्यवचः सरोजममलं गीतार्थगन्तोत्कटम् नानाख्यानकेसरं हरिकथा सम्बोधनाबोधितम् लोके सज्जन षट्पदैरहरहः पेपीयमानं मुदा भूयाद्भारत पङ्कजं कलिमल प्रध्वंसिनः श्रेयसे मूकं करोति वाचालम् पङ्गुं लङ्घयते गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वन्दे परमानन्दमाधवं यं ब्रह्मा वरुणेन्द्ररुद्रमरुतः स्तुन्वन्ति दिव्यैस्तवैः वेदैः साङ्गपदक्रमोपनिषदैः गायन्ति यं सामगाः ध्यानावस्थिततद्गतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यं योगिनो यस्यान्तं न विदुःसुरा सुरगणा देवाय तस्मै नमः देवाय तस्मै नमः
धन्यवादः भगिनि
हरि ओम्
पार्वती भगिनी वुड यू लाइक टू रिपीट आफ्टर मी
ओके मैम आई विल डू
ओके Okay, let's start. Sthane Hrishikesha Tava Prakritya.
Sthane Hrishikesha Tava Prakritya.
Jagat Prahrishyatyanurajyate Cha.
Jagat Prahrushyatyanurajyate Cha.
Rakshansi Bhitani Disho Dravanti.
Rakshansi Bhitani Disho Dravanti.
Sarve Namasyanti Cha Siddha Sanghaha.
Sarve Namasyanti Cha Siddha Sanghaha.
Tasmachatena Nameran Mahatman.
Kasmachatena Nameran Mahatman.
Gariyase Brahmanopyadikatre.
Gariyase Brahmanopyadikartre.
Ananta Devesha Jagannivasa.
Ananta Devesha Jagannivasa.
Twamaksharam Sadasattatparam Yat.
Twamaksharam Sadasattatparam Yat.
Twamadi Deva Purusha Purana.
Twamadi Deva Purusha Purana.
Twamasya Vishvasya Param Nidhanam.
Twamasya Vishvasya Param Nidhanam.
Vetasi Vedyam Cha Param Cha Dhamma.
Vetasi Vedyam Cha Param Cha Dhamma.
Tvaya Tatam Vishvam Ananta Rupa.
Tvaya Tatam Vishvam Ananta Rupa.
Vayuryam Agnir Varuna Shashanka.
Vayuryam Agnir Varuna Shashanka.
Prajapatistvam Prapitamahascha.
Prajapatistvam Prapitamahascha.
Namo Namaste Stu Sahasra Kritvah.
Namo Namaste Stu Sahasra Kritvah.
Punascha Bhuyopi Namo Namaste.
Punascha Bhuyopi Namo Namaste.
Namah Purastadhata Prishtataste.
Namah Purastadatha Prushtastaste.
Namostu Te Sarvata Eva Sarva.
Namostu Te Sarvata Eva Sarva.
Ananta Viryamita Vikramastvam.
Ananta Viryamita Vikramastvam.
Sarvam samapnoshi tatosi sarvaha.
Sarvam samapnoshi tatosi sarvaha.
Sakheti matva prasabhaya duktam.
Sakheti matva prasabhaya duktam.
He Krishna, he Yadava, he Sakheti.
हे कृष्ण हे यादव हे सखेती.
अजानता महिमानं तवेदम्.
अजानता महिमानं तवेदम्.
मया प्रमादात् प्रणयेन वापि.
मया प्रमादात् प्रणयेन वापि.
यच्च वहा सार्थम सत्कृतोऽसि
यच्च वहा सार्थम सत्कृतोऽसि
विहारशय्यासन भोजनेषु
विहारशय्यासन भोजनेषु
एकोतवाप्यच्युत तत्समक्षम्
एकोतवाप्यच्युत तत्समक्षम्
तच्छामये त्वामहमप्रमेयम्
तत्क्षामये त्वामहमप्रमेयम्
पितासि लोकस्य चराचरस्य
पितासि लोकस्य चराचरस्य
त्वमस्य पूज्यश्च गुरुर्गरीयान्
त्वमस्य पूज्यश्च गुरुर्गरीयान्
न त्वत्समोऽस्त्यभ्यधिकृतोऽन्यः
न त्वत्समोऽस्त्यभ्यधिकः कृतोऽन्यः
लोकत्रयेभ्यप्रतिमप्रभाव
लोकत्रयेभ्यप्रतिमप्रभाव
तस्मात् प्रणम्य प्रणिधाय कायम्
तस्मात् प्रणम्य प्रणिधाय कायम्
प्रसादये त्वामहमीशमीड्यम्
प्रसादये त्वामहमीशमीड्यम्
पितेव पुत्रस्य सखेव सख्युः
पितेव पुत्रस्य सखेव सख्युः
प्रियप्रियायार्हसि देव सोढुम्
प्रियः प्रियायार्हसि देव सोढुम्
धन्यवादः नेक्स्ट् वीक् आल्सो इफ् यू केन् चाण्ट् लैक् दिस् ऐ थिङ्क् आफ्टर् दट् वी केन् गो आन् टु यु नो टेकिङ्ग् टर्न्स् इन् चाण्टिङ्ग् धन्यवादः भगिनि
धन्यवादः भगिनि
सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् ॐ परं वरिष्ठं ब्रह्मिष्ठं परमानन्दरूपिणं परमार्थानन्दयतिम् सद्गुरुं प्रणतोऽस्म्यहम् सो इन् दिस् 11th चाप्टर् अर्जुना वाण्ट्स् टु एक्स्पीरियन्स् विश्वरूप ईश्वर अण्ड् हि इस् आस्किङ्ग् द लार्ड् वेदर् हि केन् हाव् द दर्शनम् आफ् विश्वरूप ईश्वर देन् लार्ड् कृष्णा सेस् इन् दीस् वर्सेस् द कमिङ्ग् वर्सेस् दट् अर्जुना It is certainly possible to have Vishwarupa Ishwara Darshanam, right? And we did analyze in the last class what exactly is Vishwarupa Ishwara. And we saw that it is not a new form of the Lord. It is not even an extraordinary form of the Lord, but it is an extraordinary way of looking at the very universe itself as the very body of the Lord. Because the very word Vishwarupam means that Vishwam meaning the universe and Rupam meaning the form, the figure or body of the Lord. Therefore, world as the body of the Lord is already available in front of me. Therefore, it need not appear newly. Even though the world, which is the body of the Lord, is available all the time, our problem is we experience the world all right, but we don't experience the world as the body of the Lord. We have Vishwa Darshanam, but we don't have Vishwarupa Ishwara Darshanam. So if we have to look at the very world as the body of the Lord, as I said, it requires two qualifications. As long as these two qualifications are absent or one of them is absent, we will experience the world, but we will never experience the world as the very Ishwara Shariram itself, right? So this we saw in the last class. So then I introduced these two factors, right? And I said it is part of the divinization project, the world divinization project, right? So what are the two qualifications? One is jnanam and the other is sannyasa. Jnanam means the knowledge of Ishwara. Second is the refinement of the mind, right? So what do you mean by the jnanam of Ishwara, right? I said God is the cause of the universe and universe is the product of Ishwara. So always the product, the effect is never different from the cause. Cause alone expresses in the form of varieties of effect. Material cause especially. Gold expresses as ornaments. Wood expresses as furniture. Cause expresses as the effect. So Bhagavan is the cause. World is the effect. Therefore, one Bhagavan alone with different Nama Rupas is appearing as this universe. So Bhagavan plus name and form is called the universe. This awareness must be there. So just as, you know, when we handle our ornaments, although we use different names called bangle, ring, chain, etc., throughout our transactions, what do we remember? That they are all golden ornaments. The word gold is what we remember all the time, or we have jnana nishta, right? That is called jnana nishta. So what is that? As Swamiji says, Sarveshu Abharaneshu, right? Gold Darshanam is Jnana Nishta. So similarly, Sarvam Jagat, in the entire world when you see Ishwara, that is Jnana Nishta, right? So this is an important point that we saw. This is the first one, right? Jnanam. So we also said we looked at the carpenter wood example. We saw the potter pot example, etc., right? So if the jnanam is there for a person who remembers para prakriti and apara prakriti, and he says everything is Bhagavan only. Now the second part, right, is even though the entire world is the body of the Lord, right, even though Bhagavan is the owner of the entire creation, we understand the first part. We accept that Bhagavan is the owner of the entire creation, right? Somehow it doesn't register, right? And what do we want to do? We want to claim a few items as mine, right? Ownership. Because of simple ignorance, we develop ahankara and mamakara with regard to a few things. With regard to body-mind complex, I develop ownership, which is called ahankara. And with regard to a few people, property, right, possession, profession, etc., we develop mamakara. And once I develop ownership, then I want to take control of them. Wherever there is ownership, I want to control, right? And the problem is I don't have control over everything. Even this very body, which is very close to me, right? And we know that it is not going to survive for long, right? But still we have uncontrollable anxiety about this body, right? So there is always anxiety in ownership. But as Swamiji puts it, we must remember, I have trespassed into the property of the Lord And Bhagavan has actually put a board, what? Trespassers will be prosecuted. And what is the prosecution of the Bhagavan on this? That is mental stress, strain, anxiety, fear, etc. Because I want to control those things which I do not have control over. If only I remember I don't have ownership, therefore I cannot control that. I only have a contributing free will. This is very useful when it comes to our own children. It can be family, it can be possession, it can be property, it can be the share market, it can be our profession also, right? Now, I only have a contributing free will. I can raise the children according to my capacity, inculcating the value systems in my family, right? We can be role models, but we do not have absolute control on how they are going to turn out, right? And at one point, you hand over the children to Bhagavan and say, okay, do what you need to do, right? No anxiety once we hand over. So every time we do namaskara, we generally think of one of these five things, and the ahankara and mamakara comes up, right? Body, mind, family, possessions, professions, right? And once the ahankara, mamakara comes, our mind gets narrower and narrower. And most of the time, our mind is occupied with, as Swamiji says, naam iruvar, namakku iruvar in Tamil. That is, we two and our two, right? So, we don't have the time to appreciate the Vishwarupa Ishvara, right? In fact, I always think I have never found the time to, you know, walk in my own terrace for so many years. One coronavirus had to do that, right? And then once you start walking and once, you know, the lockdown started, we started seeing birds that we have never before either observed or never before were allowed to be free. For 2 to 3 months when planes did not go, we could see all of these, right? Nature at its best. That is because normal days, our ahankara and mamakara is completely taking over us. We do not have the time or, you know, even the little bit of mental space to appreciate this Vishwarupa Ishvara. And once the aham and mama are diluted or eliminated, then I start living in the present, right? What will happen tomorrow, we leave it to Bhagavan. And today what I need to do, let me do, right? So in fact, there is a very famous shloka in Mukunda Mala, very nice one. Nastha dharmena vasunichaye naiva kamopa bhoge yadyad bhavyam bhavatu bhagavan purva karmanu rupam. Oh Lord, whatever has to happen according to the law of karma, let it happen. Let me not worry about what will happen, which I don't know. But let me do whatever I have to do, right? All the time, let me think about what I have to do and what I need to get done, right? So, having done that, what is my desire? Etat pratyam mama bahumatam janma janmantarepi. Tvat padam boruha yugamata nishala bhakti rastu. So let me do my duty and relax my mind and enjoy this wonderful Vishwarupam. Right? We read Rudram, you read Purusha Suktam. They're all descriptions of Shiva and Vishnu in Vishwarupa form only. Right? So the second qualification required is reduction of ahankara and mamakara, reduction of ragadvesha, which Swamiji calls, and you know, it is generally referred to as Chitta Samskara Jnanam, right? And if I have the samskara of Vishwarupa Darshanam all the time, then that is a refined mind. So therefore, Lord Krishna says, hey Arjuna, I will bless you with such a refined mind. That's what we are going to see. Continuing. Shri Bhagavanu Vacha. श्री भगवानुवाच पश्य मे पार्थ रूपाणि पश्य मे पार्थ रूपाणि शतशोत सहस्रशः शतशोत सहस्रशः नानाविधानि दिव्यानि नानाविधानि दिव्यानि नानावर्णाकृतीनि च नानावर्णाकृतीनि च। सो श्री भगवान उवाच द लॉर्ड रेस्पॉन्डेड टू अर्जुनास रिक्वेस्ट हे अर्जुन ई नीड नॉट शो यू विश्वरूपम और ई नीड नॉट इवन ब्रिंग विश्वरूपम इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू राइट सो लॉर्ड कृष्णा सेज व्हाई शुड ई ब्रिंग इट इज अवेलेबल टू यू टू सी एंड ओपन योर आईज राइट वेर एवर यू आर ओपन योर आईज इट इज विश्वरूप ईश्वर ओनली राइट हे पार्थ अर्जुन आई एम राइट इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू रूपाणि पश्य राइट So, in Bhagavatam, it is said that the universe is the first avatara of the Lord. Whereas, whenever somebody uses the word avatara, what happens? We think of Matsya, Kurma, Varaha, right? Rama avatara, etc. Right? So, and that is a Bhagavan who gives darshanam and goes away, right? But a wonderful avataram is available for all people all the time, and that is the first avatara, which is the world itself, right? So how many forms? Rupani Shatashaha. Hundreds and thousands of forms available in front of you, right? Shatashaha, Sahasrashaha. He wants to, he says tens, hundreds, then he says thousands, right? So many multiple varieties and species are there, right? So therefore, everyone is different. Every animal, every plant, every species. Therefore, Nana Vidhani. All of them are nana varna kriti nicha, of different colors and forms, right? You see in all the forests, right? We hear about newer and newer species. Even frogs, they say there are 23 species, a small thing like a frog, right? So all these keep getting discovered, right? So each one of them is divine, and we have to prepare our mind with jnanam and sannyasa to appreciate this divine form of the Lord, right? So for us now to see this, we need what we need Divya Chakshuhu, right? This beautiful world as Ishwara. So as we say, beauty is in the eye of the beholder. So we need to change, right? So the divinity is in the eye, right? Pashya, Pashya means you see it; it is already available. Continuing. पश्यादियान् वसून् रुद्रान् पश्यादित्यान् वसून् रुद्रान् अश्विनौ मरुतस्तता अश्विनौ मरुतस्तता बहून्यदृष्टपूर्वाणि बहून्यदृष्टपूर्वाणि पश्याश्चर्याणि भारत Pashyashcharyani Bharata. So Vishwarupa is not confined to only Bhuloka, right? So Vishwarupa includes all the lokas, all the higher lokas described in the Puranas as Bhuvar, Suvar Loka, etc., right? Not only are these lokas Vishwarupa, the celestial beings are also Vishwarupa. Adityan, the Dwadasha Aditya Devata that we saw in the 10th chapter, right? Then Ashtavasavaha, the 8 Vasus, and Rudran, the Ekadasha Rudraha, the 11 Rudras, Ashvinav, the 2 Ashvini Kumaras, Marutas Tataha, the 49 Marut Devatas. In short, all the celestials, right? And as well as the ordinary beings on earth, all of them are part of Vishwarupa. That is why we saw in the Vishnu Sahasranama Shloka also, after Bhupadau Yasya Nabir, the third and fourth lines, Antastam Yasya Vishwam Sura Nara Khaga Go Bhogi Gandharva Daityaihi Chitram Ram Ramyate Tam Tribhuvana Vapusham Vishnu Misham Namami. So in the Vishwarupa Shariram of the Lord, Antastam, just as we have bacteria inside, right? Bacteria for Vishwarupam also, right? Some of us are good, some of us are bad. So similarly, the world as Vishwarupam Ishwara has both good and bad things. Thus, all the devatas are Vishwarupa Ishwara only. So Bahuni Adrishta Purvani, all those things which you have not seen before, right? Ashcharyani, which are full of wonderment, right? Ashcharyam means extraordinary, wonderful things, right? only as you require a special goggle to see a 3D movie, you need this eye for divinization, right? It is already available. Continuing. Ihaikastam jagat kritsnam. Ihaikastam jagat kritsnam. Pashyadya sacharacharam. Pashyadya sacharacharam. Mama dehe gudakesha. Mama dehe gudakesha. Yachanyadrashtumichasi. Very simple Sanskritam in these portions. I'm sure you'll be able to follow. Here, Lord Krishna makes it very clear. Vishwarupam is not a special form which came into the world and went away. Because Lord Krishna says, Vishwarupam is just the entire world, right, in its infinity, right? So, in the Upanishad, we get lot of descriptions about the world itself, right? So, if we have a background of Upanishad, then it is easier to understand Vishwarupa Darshanam. For instance, in Taittiriya Sikshavali, there is a Pankta Brahman, right? The fivefold, right? And a discussion happens on Pankta Brahman, and it is made up of the world being made up of Panchabhutaha. How does the world evolve? What is the sequence? Everything is discussed in detail in Taittiriya Upanishad, right? So, thus, Vishwarupa Ishvara is not a temporary form which is just coming and going. So, Lord Krishna says, Akasha is the very body of the Lord. That is the description, right? Iha, in this body of mine, which is the very Akasha itself, Kritsnam Jagat Sacharacharam Pashya. See my body consisting of the entire universe, not only the universe, including chara, achara. Chara means moving living beings, right? And achara means non-moving living beings, right? So the non-moving living beings are what? The plants, trees, etc., right? That's why in our culture, we worship all of them. So, sachara acharam pashya. Then, asya, here and now it is available. Mama dehe, in my body, infinite body of mine, gudakesha. Gudakesha, we have already seen a very favorite expression Lord Krishna uses again and again. Gudaka means nidra. So a person who has conquered nidra, the student who is awake, attentive and alert is called gudakesha. So, hey gudakesha, he is addressing Arjuna here, right? Yachya anyat drashtum ichasi. Whatever you want to see, everything is already available. When it is already available, if you cannot see Vishwarupa Ishvara, the problem is not with me, but you have got an obstacle, which is called in Guru Stotram, Ajnana Timirandasya. You have got a cataract of a different form, and the cataract has to be removed, which is Jnanam and Antara Ahankara Mamakara Sanyasa. That has to be removed. That's all. The Vishwarupa Ishvara is ever available in front of you. Natu Mam Shakya Se Drashtum. Natu Mam Shakya Se Drashtum. Anenaiva Svachakshusha. Anenaiva Svachakshusha. Divyam dadami te chakshuhu. Divyam dadami te chakshuhu. Pashyame yoga maishwaram. Pashyame yoga maishwaram. So Lord Krishna blesses Arjuna with a refined perception which he calls divya chakshuhu. Without that divya chakshu, you will be lost in family worries. You cannot see Bhagavan. Therefore, he says, Anenaiva Svachakshusha, with your own ordinary eyes, right? You cannot, if it is backed with Raga Dvesha, Ahankara and Mamakara, with that ordinary eye, Mam Drashtum Na Shakyase, you will not be able to see the Vishwarupa Ishvara in me, right? You will only see Vishwam. Therefore, दिव्यम ददामि ते चक्षु, देयरफॉर आई विल ब्लेस यू विद दिव्य चक्षु, राइट? ऑफ दीज टू फैक्टर्स ऑफ दिव्य चक्षु, ज्ञानम एंड संन्यास. ज्ञानम पार्ट लॉर्ड कृष्णा हैज ऑलरेडी गिवन टू अर्जुन इन चैप्टर 7, 9, and 10. What was that jnanam? Para, para, prakriti. We saw in detail, right? And also the glories of the Lord, right? But the second part is what? Ahankara, mamakara, abolishing. This Arjuna has not done. Therefore, Krishna says, I will bless you with that. Therefore, divyam chakshuhu te aham dadami, right? So if you read Rudram, at the end of the Rudram, there is a beautiful sentence. Oh Lord, I am trying to have your darshanam somewhere, and it says you are here itself. In what form? I am me hastau bhagavan, I am me bhagavataraha. This hand which I am going to use for doing puja, this hand, right? First he tells the left hand and then he tells the right hand also, right? So that is itself Shiva. The glory is Shiva, right? So everything is Ishvara Swarupam, right? So Vishwarupa Darshanam, Vishwarupa Darshanam Ishvara is right in front of you, right? I am me hastau bhagavan, right? This is more auspicious with the first he says left hand, then he says right hand, because with the right hand I'm going to handle the murti, right? So here Krishna says divyam chakshu aham dadami me aishwaram yogam, my power as my divine power, right? Aishwaram means divine. Yoga means glory or power or manifestation. Me pashya. Then you have to imagine. Okay. So there is some silence in between. Normally the ahankara and mamakara have to be diluted by what? Very long sadhana called karma yoga and upasana yoga. We have seen that. Raga, dvesha, ahankara, mamakara dilution will happen through, which is Chitta Shuddhi, will happen through long sadhana of Karma Yoga through Pancha Mahayajna and Upasana Yoga through Ishta Devata Upasana, preferably Nishkama Upasana, right? So they are two different methods of rubbing off Aham and Mama, right? So you start serving others and use the meditation to dilute the Aham and Mama. But here Lord Krishna is blessing Arjuna, we must remember, with a temporary dilution of aham and mama, right? So artificial dilution. Therefore, Arjuna is getting transformed. Now, as Swamiji puts it, if it's a movie, right, then you can dramatize, right? Krishna showing the hand and rays coming and painting Arjuna and then a glow is coming. All that we can do. But Vyasacharya can't do all this, right? So what can he do in his verse, right? So there is silence now and we have to see the transformation on the part of Arjuna, right? So since there is silence, Lord Krishna is not talking. He's not talking, right? So Arjuna is also not talking. No, therefore, Dhritarashtra, we must not forget him, who is there on the other end, will be wondering what is happening, right? So you hope you all remember that the way the Gita started in the first chapter was, Dhritarashtra was there, right? And it started with Dharma Kshetre, Kuru Kshetre, and Sanjaya started reporting the events to Dhritarashtra, right? If you remember, in this continued entire first chapter, he reported. And in chapter 2, verse 1, Sanjaya spoke, Tam tata kripaya vishtam ashrupurna kulekshanam. He talked about Arjuna being overpowered with grief, right? And even in verse 9, Sanjaya said, Eva muktva Hrishikesham Gudakesha Parantapa. So he said that Krishna started the Gita teaching and then Arjuna kept quiet, right? So Sanjaya spoke like this in chapter 2, verses 1 and 9. We are now in 11th chapter. Sanjaya has not spoken a single verse till now, okay? Now, because there is silence from Krishna's side and Arjuna's side, Sanjaya comes and he is giving the description of Vishwarupa Ishwaraha. That means what? Sanjaya also enjoys Divya Chakshuhu. Either because he's already refined Or Vyasacharya has blessed Sanjaya also to have such refined perception. Therefore, in the following shlokas, we get Vishwarupa Varnanam done by Sanjaya. So, until now, Lord Krishna described Vishwarupa from where verses 5 to 8, right? Varnanam by Krishna. Now, we get the Vishwarupa description by Sanjaya. Thereafter, Arjuna with Divya Chakshuhu will give his description. So, Krishna speaks about himself briefly. Then Sanjaya describes Vishwarupa. Following that, Arjuna will, with Divya Chakshuhu, give his description. So, what does Sanjaya say? We will read. Okay, there is a lag now and then. Is there a problem with the audio? You can send me a message. I'll see after the slide. Sanjaya Uvacha, Sanjaya Uvacha, Eva Muktva Tato Rajan, Eva Muktva Tato Rajan, Mahayogeshwaro Harihi, Mahayogeshwaro Harihi, Darshayamasa Parthaya, Darshayamasa Parthaya, Paramam Rupam Aishwaram, Paramam Rupam Aishwaram. So Sanjaya reports to Dhritarashtra. Evam Uktva, after addressing Arjuna in this manner, from verse 5 to 8, right? Having addressed Arjuna, Tataha thereafter, here Rajan, who is Rajan here? Dhritarashtra. Mahayogeshwaro Harihi. Harihi means the Lord, the great Lord, who is the Lord of all. Maya Shakti. Yogaha means Yoga Maya. Mayayaha Ishwaraha means the Lord of Maya Shakti. Therefore, Lord Krishna has the power to temporarily remove Arjuna's Ahankara and Mamakara. But remember that it is only temporary. It has to be permanently removed. So for that, we have to work on Karma Yoga and Upasana Yoga. That is the regular method. Now Lord Krishna has temporarily removed. Now therefore he says Mahayogeshwaraha, that omnipotent Lord did this job for Arjuna. Like what Swamiji gives an interesting analogy. Now if the children's homework, right, is too much and the parents decide to start doing the homework, and then when the exam comes, how will the children fare, right? It's exactly like that. Now, Lord Krishna is doing the homework for Arjuna. That is why the benefit will last only up to 11th chapter, not even up to the end of 11th chapter. Because Arjuna is not able to get the real benefit, but Arjuna gets a glimpse of what is Vishwarupa Darshanam because of Krishna's blessings. So, with this blessing, Darshayamasa Parthaya, Lord Krishna made Arjuna experience the Vishwarupa Ishwara by changing the attitude towards the world itself. Paramam Rupam, this great form, Ishwaram, which is divine, right? Which is the Vishwarupa Darshanam, Darshayamasa, showed to Partha, that is Arjuna. So Sanjaya starts describing. Aneka Vaktra Nayanam. Aneka Vaktra Nayanam. Aneka Vaktra Nayanam. Aneka Adbhuta Darshanam. Aneka Adbhuta Darshanam. Aneka Divyabharanam. Aneka Divyabharanam. Divyanekadhyat. Divyanekadhyatayudam. Divyanekad. Something is wrong here. I will correct it. Just one second. Anekavaktranayanam. Anekadbhutadarshanam. Anekadivyabharanam. Divyanekodhyatayudam. दिव्यमाल्याम्बरधरम् दिव्यमाल्याम्बरधरम् दिव्यगन्धानुलेपनम् दिव्यगन्धानुलेपनम् सर्वाश्चर्यमयम् देवम् सर्वाश्चर्यमयम् देवम् अनन्तं विश्वतोमुखम् अनन्तं विश्वतोमुखम् सो द डिस्क्रिप्शन् आफ् विश्वरूप संजय गिव्स् हियर् रैट् कृष्णः दर्शयामास यु शुड् आड् हियर् आल्सो लार्ड् कृष्ण शोड् द विश्वरूप रैट् अनेक वक्त्रनयनं द लार्ड् एण्डोर्ड् वित् थौसण्ड्स् आफ् हेड्स् वक्त्रं मीन्स् हेड् अण्ड् नयनं मीन्स् ऐस् रैट् so vaktram can also mean mouth so once we say lord with thousands of heads our imagination goes to the photograph with so many heads sticking out and how will bhagavan balance etc right so we should it's a symbolic representation so what do we mean by vishwarupa ishwara with thousands of heads we must note that all the various peoples right heads mouths eyes are all belonging to Vishwarupa Ishwara right and which we claim as mine right our own eyes our own body everything right so once the ahankara and mamakara are removed then we see everything as Ishwara's eyes only aneka vaktra nayanam every mouth every eye is bhagavan's right and aneka adbhuta darshanam not only that the universe is full of wonders all the wonders that are in the universe belongs to ishvara right ishvarah aneka adbhuta darshanam aneka divya varanam right again we think oh bhagavan with one head will wear all the ornaments and you know his neck will break how will he balance etc no right all the ornaments that are there in all the people right which we claim as our own in the vision of the vishwarupa bhakta nobody is the owner of any ornament all ornaments in anybody's body is owned by one bhagavan only right so therefore previously the ornament was owned by you and me that was ordinary but when I see it as bhagavan's it becomes divya bharanam right so similar to if when somebody gives us a piece of laddu we just take it and immediately put it in our mouth whereas if it is a tirupati laddu we don't put it in our mouth we take it we touch it with our eyes and then we have the laddu as naivedyam with the reverence right so then it becomes divyam right so for vishwarupa bhakta right sarvam everything is to be revered and even when he goes to have a bath in the river he will first pray gange cha yamune sindhu then only he will do the prokshanam and then only he will have a bath and he treats the bath also is a holy puja to the lord right so all ornaments vishwarupa bhakta sees as divyam divya malyam varadaram every mala is divyam and aneka divya varanam right so every ornament belongs to bhagavan divya aneka udyata ayudam here he says that why because arjuna is in the battlefield people are holding all types of weapons that's why if you see the picture photograph of vishwarupa ishwara you see all types of weapons being held there after all the picture of the vishwarupa has come based on the descriptions that we see in the gita so that is how it is picturized right but here particularly we must note that this because it is the battlefield and several weapons are there that krishna talks about divya aneka udyata ayudam right so every one of these weapons right which are all ready for operation belongs to vishwarupa ishwara right every dress of everyone belongs to me divya gandanu lepanam every ambaram then every perfume right the chandanam the all kinds of perfumes belong to vishwarupa ishwara in short word sarva aashcharyamayam devam everything in this creation is wonderful right how big it is vishwarupam is a form that came and went then it will be finite it is not a particular form and therefore it is infinite right so here the description given is anantam right anantam and Vishvato Mukham, right? Because we have all become, see, we don't even look and appreciate the universe, right? So here we become like the frog in the well. Therefore, Anantam Vishvato Mukham, with face. Here, Bhagavan's face is turned in all directions. Because different faces are turned in different directions, it is Anantam Vishvato Mukham. We do not have the time to stand and appreciate this beautiful vision of the Lord, right? So that is what is said here. Sanjaya describes, continuing. Divi Surya Sahasrasya, Divi Surya Sahasrasya, Bhaved Yuga Padutita, Bhaved Yuga Padutita, Yadi Bhasadrishi Sasyat, Yadi Bhasadrishi Sasyat, Bhasastasya Mahatmanaha, Bhasastasya Mahatmanaha. So how brilliant the Lord is described. If the whole creation is Ishvara, all the stars are also Ishvara, right? So what is the brilliance of one star, right? Which is the nearest one. We know that Surya, the brilliance of one sun, we are not able to endure, right? So here we are talking about multiple stars and we are saying Divi in the sky, Surya Sahasrasya, thousands and thousands of sun or stars, Yugapat Uttita, if they are simultaneously rising, right? Imagine, and if it's close to us, right? So such brilliance, right? That is what is described here. That much will be the brilliance of thousands of sun arising simultaneously. Yati Bhasyat, if you add the brilliance of all the stars together, Tasya Mahatmanaha Sa Bhasyat, the total brilliance is the brilliance of Vishwarupa Ishvara. We can only imagine, we cannot actually experience because our body and sense organs are not designed for this, right? So, as Swamiji says, even mountaineers who trek, right, they need to do so much of practice and improve their endurance, right, to be able to go up. So, imagine this kind of brilliance, right? So, and that too, this reflected light of multiple stars, not one star, right? So, that is Vishwarupa Mahima. Therefore, he says, Tasya Mahatmanaha. Here, Mahatma means Vishwarupa Ishwarasya Bhaha. Bhaha means brilliance, which will be the total of all the multiple suns rising together. Okay? Continuing. Tatraikastam Jagat Krishnam. Tatraikastam Jagat Krishnam. Pravibhaktam Anekada. Pravibhaktam Anekada. Upashyat Deva Devasya. Apashyat Deva Devasya. Sharire Pandavastada. Sharire Pandavastada. It's apashyat. Yeah, apashyat Deva Devasya. Here also Sanjaya clearly says, Vishwarupa Ishvara is not one particular form of God which appeared in the battlefield and disappeared. If it is a form like that, then that form will be finite, right? So Sanjaya says it's not a particular form which came and stood over the earth. Really speaking, all the universes are existing within that Vishwarupa, right? So what does it mean? It is not a form in the world, but the whole world is existing in that. In such a case, the body of the Lord can be only one thing. It has to be the all-pervading Akasha, right? And therefore, he says, Tatra, in that body of the Lord, which is the Akasha, right? The infinite space, right? That is the body of the Lord. In that body, Ekastam, right? How many spaces are there? It is one. It is an all-pervading spatial body of Bhagavan. Kritsnam Jagat, the entire universe consisting of millions of galaxies, right? To know the size of the universe, in fact, you should go and see the models of the universe, the galaxies, how, you know, the sun rotates and how the planets rotate. The sun itself is rotating at some speed of some mind-boggling speed of 70,000 kilometers something per second, and you can go and see those models, right? This whole thing is Bhagavan's body, right? So you can consider all of these put together, right? So if you see in front of these galaxies, sun itself becomes a grain. Then in front of the sun, Jupiter is such a small thing. Then in front of that, the earth is so small. And then in that earth, in one corner, in one country, in one city, we are one small speck of some 60-70 kg person sitting in a corner, right? Just like a dust, right? So, and we make so much fuss over that dust particle called our body, right? And we miss the Vishwarupa Ishwaram, right? So it's a very beautiful comparative study. Therefore, all galaxies are dust particles in the Vishwarupa Ishwara, and they are all Anekada Pravibhaktam, divided into many clusters, right? Each galaxy is a cluster of stars, right? So to enjoy Vishwarupa Varnanam, as Swamiji says, you have to read astronomy books. Only then you will be able to even picturize how big it can even be, right? It's mind-boggling. And Bhagavan includes everything. Therefore, Pravibhaktam Anekada Apashyata Deva Devasya Sharire. In the spatial body of Vishwarupa Ishwara, spatial body, that is the space of the body of Ishwara, Apashyata means Arjuna saw. We must remember that Sanjaya is reporting to Dhritarashtra that Arjuna is able to see, right? Because his Ahankara and Mamakara are suppressed. Why Ahankara and Mamakara had to be suppressed for Arjuna? You must remember this, because I might have missed this or you might have missed this. In the first chapter, what did Arjuna do? He cried, right? He was only attached to a few people and he asked this question. How can I live without Bhishma? How can I live without Drona? Our Raga, you must remember in the first chapter, right? Too much of Raga and he had the Samsara, right? That was the problem. Because of Ahankara and Mamakara, right? Raga, the mind was preoccupied, right? Raga means attachment, resulting Shoka means worry, and then Moha means delusion. Because of Raga, Shoka and Moha, that Arjuna forgot the duty, why he has come to fight this war. And therefore, he was so filled with Ahankara and Mamakara. And when the mind is preoccupied with worry and conflict, he cannot see the wonderful blessings of the Vishwarupa Ishwara. The mind does not allow that, right? Because it was so full of Ahankara and Mamakara. And we must remember that Krishna blessed Arjuna with Divya Chakshuhu, and therefore he saw, and Sanjaya is reporting that here, right? So we saw that from the from verse 9 to, yeah, we still have one more verse to go, right? Till that he, Sanjaya, is describing the Vishwarupa Ishwara, right? And if you remember, even in Vishnu Sahasranamam, we see the same concept. Vishwadharam Gagana Sadrisham Meghavarnam Shubhangam. Vishwadharam Gagana Sadrisham. The body is all pervading as Akasha, and in that Akasha Shariram, the Lord of the Lord, Sanjaya sees all the lokas and all the living beings, divine and in manifold form. Therefore, Anekada Pravibhaktam Kritsnam Jagat Deva Devasya Sharire Apashyat. Deva Devaha means God of all gods, the ultimate God. Right? Continuing. Tatasavismaya Vishtaha Rishtaromadananjayah Pranamya Shirasa Devam Kritanjalira Bhashata. So when Arjuna gets this Vishwarupa Darshanam, Arjuna goes through three emotional states or three emotional responses. The first immediate response is one of Ashcharyam or Vismaya. One of the wonder, because everything in this creation is extraordinary. we can never imagine creating any one of them. A mosquito can be destroyed in half a second, but the entire humanity cannot produce this mosquito, right? We cannot produce anything, right, that we destroy like this, which nature has given to us, right? So the more you see the creation, the more wonderful it is. And therefore, Ashcharyam Vismaya is the first response. Thereafter, Arjuna gradually goes from wonderment to bhayam, because the world is not only one of the beautiful things, but the world has got equally dangerous things like old age, diseases, the virus now, and death, etc. So when we see one or two, we can perhaps manage, but when we see so many, right, and here it is the battlefront, right? So you can see lot of bad things also. And so when Arjuna sees that, from Ashcharyam he goes to bhayam. Then there's the third and final emotional state. So Arjuna goes to the stage of surrender or bhakti, right? Because Vishwarupa is too huge and too vast, right? And our intellect is so small and petty. So, and Arjuna's emotional state is Sharanagati. This Ashcharya, Bhaya, Bhakti, he goes through all the three stages. Therefore, Sanjaya says, Tataha, after seeing the vast glory of the universe, Saha Dhananjayaha, Arjuna Vismaya Vishta. Avishtaha means overpowered by wonderment, right? The Ashcharya, the wonderment influenced his mind so that such a way that the reaction was expressed at the bodily level also. So Hrishtaroma here means goosebumps, horripilation, goosebumps. He had goosebumps. So Hrishtaroma Dhananjayaha Vismaya Vishtaha Sam Shirasa Devam Pranamya. So he wanted to express gratitude to the Lord, right, for giving this Divya Chakshuhu. Therefore, he offered Namaskara and Kritanjali with folded hands, right? With Namaskara Mudra Abhashata, Arjuna spoke these words. Until now, Arjuna could not have the balance. Now only he is gathering to utter a few words, right? Because he went through the three states. And now we get Vishwarupa Darshana, Vishwarupa description by Arjuna. So Vyasacharya, to highlight this change in Arjuna, what option does he have? He can only change the meter of the shloka, right? Because you cannot have any background music or anything. So that is what Vyasacharya is doing. Arjuna uvacha, Arjuna uvacha, Pashyami devanstava deva dehe, Pashyami devanstava deva dehe, Sarvanstatha bhuta vishesha sanghan, Sarvanstatha bhuta vishesha sanghan, Brahmanamisham kamalasanastham, Brahmanamisham kamalasanastham, Rishinsha sarvan uragamsha divyan, Rishinsha sarvan uragamsha divyan. From the description of Vishwarupa, we recognize one thing. Arjuna's Divya Chakshuhu must be something extremely special, right? So, what we see as divine is a divine expression of the Lord, right? That is the regular Divya Chakshuhu, which once you cross over the Ahankara and Mamakara, you can appreciate the divinity in the world, right? That is the regular one, right? So, divinization of the world, which is required for spiritual growth, right? So from Ekarupa Ishvara, we go to Vishwarupa Ishvara. Then of course, we go to Arupa Nirguna Ishvara. Now, this vision you assume as exalted vision, right? You assume this. Now, Arjuna has got an additional dimension also, because this Divya Chakshuhu is given by Bhagavan. Therefore, some speciality must be there. Therefore, he has an additional factor, and that is in addition to exalted vision. Arjuna has extended vision also. So Arjuna had an extended range of vision. Why extended? In both time and space. normal vision of our world is we can experience only a segment of Bhuloka. Our eyes are designed to experience Bhuloka only, right? The other higher lokas described in the Shastra, like Bhuvar Loka, Suvar Loka, Mahar Loka, the celestials in those lokas, we only hear the descriptions. We are not able to see, but Arjuna got that extended vision to see all of them as well as the celestials also. So this Swamiji refers to as extended, because time wise and space wise extended, right? So he sees not only the present, he also sees the future also, right? Because he has this Divya Chakshuhu, he know he is going to see who are all going to die and who are all going to survive, right? In a symbolic form, some of the warriors in the battlefield are going to enter the mouth of the Lord and Bhagavan is swallowing them, Kala Tattvam, and some of them are directly swallowed and some of them are being crushed in the teeth of the Bhagavan, right? You see all this in the picture, that the Vishwarupa Darshana picture, if you have, you can see that. So the future is represented by Bhagavan's mouth and he sees the death of so many people. This is time-wise extension. So seeing the celestials is space-wise extension and something like telepathy he gets. And of course, he also sees, so Bhuvar Loka and other lokas he sees. And of course, he sees the time-wise extension also with the, so Arjuna is enjoying both exalted and extended vision, right, through the Divya Chakshuhu, right? Therefore, the description is also like that, right? He Deva, O Lord, Tava Dehe, in your body, Aham Devana Pashyami. I am not only seeing the people of the Bhuloka, I am getting the experience of higher lokas as well as the celestials, right? Bhuta Vishesha Sangan, as well as different types of beings in different lokas, right? I am able to see all of them and my vision is able to reach to Brahma Loka and I am able to see the Lord Brahma, Brahmanam Isham Kamalasanastam. Isham Brahmanam, right? The Brahma who is in Kamalasana, lotus seat. Here the lotus seat represents the universe, the entire universe. Presiding over the universe, right? I experience Brahma. Not only that, Rishim Cha Sarvan, I'm able to experience the celestial rishis, the Deva rishis also. And I'm able to see Divyan Uragana Cha Uragan, means the reptiles or snakes. Here the celestial snakes, Ananta, Vasuki, etc. I am able to experience all of them in your infinite body as an integral part of your body. Continuing. Aneka Bahu Daravatra Netram. Aneka Bahu Daravatra Netram. Pashyamitvam Sarvatonantarupam. Pashyami Tvam Sarvato Nantarupam Nantam Namadhyam Napunastavadim Nantam Namadhyam Napunastavadim Pashyami Vishveshwara Vishwarupa Pashyami Vishveshwara Vishwarupa. Hey Vishveshwara, O Lord of the Universe, right? Aham Tvam Pashyami, I experience you as not one special form standing in front. I experience you as all the living beings. How? Aneka Bahudara Vaktra Netram. I see hundreds, thousands of hands, stomachs, right? Mouth and eye, right? Previously, I would have attributed them to Pandavas and Kauravas, but I no longer look upon them in their eyes, but they are all Sahasra Shirsha Purushaha, basically all bodies and eyes are all yours only, right? And they are all located Sarvataha, Anantarupam, in all directions, right? So Arjuna says it is all pervading Anantarupam, right? And there is no arrival or departure for such a Vishwarupam. Your Vishwarupa is all pervading. Previously, I missed them, I now appreciate them. And Arjuna clearly says, na antam, there is no upper limit. Na adim, there is no beginning, there is no middle also, right? There is no middle, end or beginning, right? It is infinite, नान्तं न मध्यं न पुनस्तवादिं हे विश्वरूप अहं न पश्यामि राइट अर्लियर आई डिड नॉट सी नाउ आई एम एबल टू सी ओ लॉर्ड विद द यूनिवर्सल फॉर्म ओके सो वी विल स्टॉप हियर एंड कंटिन्यू विद अर्जुनास डिस्क्रिप्शन इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास पूर्णमद पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ओम शांति 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 एनी क्वेश्चंस आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू सी Yeah, there are a few questions. Divya Gandhanu Lepanam, divine perfume. With limited knowledge, we can understand Sanjaya reporting what he says or what others speak. How is that he is able to report or describe even the perfumes? Because he has Divya Chakshuhu. He is blessed, right? So, Divya Gandhanu Lepanam, same thing, same question. So basically he has Divya Chakshuhu, he's blessed with Divya perception. You take Divya Chakshuhu as divine perception, right? So it's technically eyes are used to represent the sense organs. He's able to perceive. If you see later on in the description, Arjuna is able to perceive everything and he's also able to, exhibit fright, and wonderment, etc. So you can just treat Chakshu as representing sense organ, right? Okay. There are no questions. Can you please put the Mukunda Mala Stotram you were referring to in the website along with the Gita Shlokas? Okay. I will put it in one slide after that and put it up. The Shloka and Mukunda Mala. Definitely will do it. Any other questions? Let me just see. I don't think there are any questions, and there are no hands also raised there. Yeah, there is a question here. Mohana, you can go ahead.
Namaskara, Mahodaya.
This I want to share with you. And you said Sanjaya, how he can smell the perfume. Can you believe that I have this problem? If I see a person smoking on the TV, I can smell cigarette. I have tested it so many times, you know. Any smell, it will come on the TV, it just drives me crazy. I've checked and checked. I think it is muscle memory or what. My father was a cigarette smoker 24 hours, so maybe it's inside me. I hate it, and I can smell the same thing with smell. If anything, I can smell a person. It's I don't know whether it's good or bad. And bad things and good things I can smell.
You should just take it as Chakshuhu representing all sense organs.
Yeah, right? So that's what when I can do, Sanjay must be so great that I'm sure he can smell everything. So that's all I wanted to share. Thank you.
Thank you, Danya. Anybody else? Okay. So next week also we will definitely chant and repeat. So Parvati Bhagini, if you're there, I would request you to chant after me so that it will be useful for others. So Hari Om, and so next week we will join in at 8:20 like today. Thank you.